Hello and welcome all of you. I'm happy that you are listening to us today. My name is Arne Müller. I'm an expert for electronic controls and I'm working in the sales and product management department of Danfoss Electronic Controls and Services. In the second part, we will have Thierry Leguet, our application expert. I'm glad to introduce you in the first part our newest controller range, the MCX15 and 20B2. In the second part, Thierry will explain you how we manage our compressors. Let's get started. The MCX platform has been widely used in a lot of products in cooling, especially also in supermarket. As you can see in this video, Danfoss offers a lot of products for heating, refrigeration and air conditioning. With our MCX and System Manager, we integrate drives, sensors and regulators. Everything works seamless. This is the advantage of a one-stop shop. Here now you can see our MCX integrated in our infrastructure, so you can use this as a system controller for your applications like air conditioning units, like ventilation units, chiller units or rooftop units or heat pumps and a lot of other applications. Then you can integrate it with gateways in the building or with the system manager to our Alsense IoT cloud services. We also now available with a new controller you can directly connect to our cloud system. With the Danfoss Alsense cloud, we already connect more than 1 million devices and we offer a lot of services, for example, energy optimization, alarm management. But you can see on other stages, you get some more information about our cloud offerings. We offer a full range of programmable controller, like small ones, the MCX06, and now our newest one, here's the MCX20B2, where we enhanced a lot of things like connectivity, safety, and performance. We have on this controller now more in and outputs, and we also add a new microprocessor inside and an AD converter that this processor is much faster in execution. And if you read the sensor, you are able also to make more precise measurements on such a controller. We also have a 6 times bigger memory on this controller and we also add an ultra wide range power supply from 24 volt up to 230 volt. This is good, you can now connect all your power like you want, but also it protects your device if someone uses a wrong power connection. On top of this, we add a lot of connectivity. We have now on this controller an Ethernet port and also a USB port. With the Ethernet port, you can directly connect from remotely over VPN channel or you can connect over our cloud infrastructure. I will show you more in the next slide about this. And then we have the USB port that you can use to download data from the controllers. And also you can connect directly your PC to upgrade your software and other things. On top of this, we have two RS-485 serial lines where you can communicate to field devices like inverter compressors, like turbo core compressors, or other field devices like fans, energy meters, and so on. And with the second line, then you can transmit data to building management system. We also have a CAN bus interface to communicate between controllers in a big network to exchange very fast data between controllers. But the main improvement is on our security for our web connectivity, because this is the future. And here we invest a lot because we want only to give you very secured products. We have a secured web server which integrates special handling of data. We always by boot, we are checking the digital signature and check that there's a right application and firmware running on the controller. And also if you make an update, we are always checking the digital signature inside the controller that is not possible to have unauthorized software or firmware updates. We're using only secured protocol like TLS 1.2 or HTTPS, the same like you are using for your online banking. And we can also monitoring and track all things, what is changed, who has done what and can share this by email with you, or you can download this information. And if someone enters the password more times wrong, we will block him. Here you can see an overview how it looks. The web server we already integrate for you. So you can easily set your parameters, you can see your alarms, you can also see the physical IOs of the controller and can override and test them. You can also have a real-time chart that you see all the data of the controller in real-time, and everything is available also from remotely, so you can directly connect from your home to your controllers and your unit. And also you can upgrade the unit from home. We also give you the availability of history data, so you also have all the data from the past available. This is already done and you can use it, but you can also customize these web pages with your logos and can optimize this with some other drawings and pictures for your needs. All our controllers are also very easy to program. We allow you directly to program in C++. Or you can use our MCX design, where we have a lot of library inside and functional blocks, what makes it very easy to build up your application very fast and quick. We also have a tool for services, the MCX Shape, that you can use for configuration, or your service guy can use it in the field. But now let's see how easy it is to manage our compressor. Let's turn to Thierry.
Thank you, Arne. Hello, my name is Thierry Leguet. I'm compressor and application expert in Danfoss Cooling. In order to facilitate your design job, Danfoss has developed some libraries that facilitate integration of variable speed compressor in your unit. Those libraries cover the most important function to protect compressor, like envelope control, oil return control, or discharge temperature control. Let us take the example of envelope control. Compressor envelope is defined by both evaporating and condensing temperature. The algorithm we develop is permanently monitoring the operating point of compressor and check that compressor is running within envelope. If compressor is running outside envelope, compressor speed is smoothly reduced or increased depending on area. If for any reason compressor is running outside envelope for more than a transient time, an alarm is generated. Let me show you in real how it works. On this training unit here, we have an MCX installed with the algorithm inside controlling the variable speed compressor behind. Here we see the compressor operating envelope. The actual running point is the red dot here. The permanent area is the blue area in the middle, and all area around are transient area. Here we have the demanding speed, the actual speed, and the zone number. In this example, speed demand is 90%, actual speed is 90%, and zone number is 1. When compressor crossing the envelope and go in zone 5 in high pressure ratio, the speed demand is smoothly reduced to get back inside envelope. When compressor is back in envelope, compressor speed is increased again, and so on and so on. This library can be easily inserted in MCX design software. MCX Design Software is a software you use to make your own application. In this library, you can find all major components to define your own application. Here we see the VZH map control block. It has some input, such evaporating temperature, condensing temperature, compressor speed demand. It has some output, such corrected speed or alarms, and of course, some parameter to define the behavior of the block. All VZH envelope has already been coded inside and you just have to choose the right compressor in the parameter. Those library has been designed in a very flexible way so you can easily insert it in your own application. But Danfoss is also offering some predefined application that you can fine-tune by yourself. And this is it.
Thank you, Thierry. You see, connectivity, safety, enhanced system performance is easier than ever. Please check out our MCX controller and inverter compressors in your unit and see how efficient it works. We are now available for your questions, so please come in the chat or check out other stages on our wonderful event here. You can also find additional information on our website in the store for getting more documentations, or you can directly in the cool selector select your compressor. Thank you again and have a nice day.